Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Stream Commerce. So today I am going to teach contract costing. Method number 5, balance sheet. So in this method we are going to prepare contract accounts as well as balance sheet as mentioned in the question. So let us start with question number 8. The following trial balance was extracted on 31st December 2013. So in the given table the expenses are given. On the debit side land and building, bank balance, contract account information is given, that is material, plant, wages, expenses. On the credit side, capital, sundry creditors, cash received, which is 90% of work certified, is given. The contract price is rupees 5 lakhs. It began on 1st January 2013. Out of the plant and materials charged to the contract, plant costing rupees 4000 and materials costing rupees 6000 were destroyed by an accident. On 31st December 2013, plant costing rupees 10000 was returned to stores. The value of material on site was rupees 5000 and the cost of work done but not certified was rupees 10000, that is work uncertified. Depreciate plant at 10% per annum and 2% on land and building. Prepare contract account after taking 2/3 profit on cash basis to profit and loss account and balance sheet as on 31st December 2013. So let us start preparing contract account for the year ended 31st December 2013. So the first expense of contract account is given as material, which is 1 lakh. So we'll record it on the debit side to materials. Amount is 1 lakh. Next is wages. Amount is 1,50,000. So we'll record it on the debit side to wages. Amount is rupees 1,50,000. Next we'll record expenses. Amount is given as 10,000. So we'll record it on the debit side to expenses. Amount is rupees 10,000. Now we'll record plant, which is 40,000. So to plant, amount is 40,000. Plant costing rupees 4,000 was destroyed by an accident. So we'll record this on the credit side of the contract account by profit and loss account, that is loss on plant. Amount is rupees 4,000. Material costing rupees 6,000 were destroyed by an accident. So this also we'll record it in contract account on the credit side by profit and loss account, loss on materials, which will be rupees 6,000. Next, on 31st December 2013, plant costing rupees 10,000 was returned to stores and depreciation on plant is given as 10%. So we'll calculate the amount of depreciation on plant. So let us prepare working notes for calculation of depreciation on plant. So working note number 1. Plant returned amount is 10,000 and depreciation is of 10%, which will be 1,000. So the amount of plant will be 9,000. So we'll record it on the credit side by plant returned. Amount is rupees 9,000. Next, the value of materials on site was rupees 5,000. So we'll record it on the credit side under work in progress. Materials at site amount is rupees 5,000. Plant amount is given as 40,000. So we have to prepare working notes for calculation of plant at site. So we record it on the credit side, plant at site. Working notes. Working note number 2, plant at site. So as per the trial balance, the amount of plant is given as 40,000. So we'll record it in the table as per the trial balance. The amount of plant is 40,000. And we'll subtract the amount of plant costing 4,000, which is destroyed by an accident. So less lost 4,000. And plant costing rupees 10,000 was returned to stores. So we'll subtract this returned. Amount is 10,000. So the total amount which should be subtracted will be 14,000. So the amount will be rupees 26,000. Depreciation on plant is given as 10% per annum. So we'll subtract depreciation at the rate of 10%, which will be rupees 2,600. So the total amount of plant at site will be rupees 23,400. So we'll record it on the credit side, plant at site amount is rupees 23,400. Now we'll record work certified amount. So cash received 90% of work certified. So we need to prepare working notes. Working note number 3, calculation of work certified. So work certified is equal to cash received into 90% of work certified, which will be equal to rupees 2,70,000 into 100 divided by 90, which was 90% of work certified, which will be equal to rupees 3 lakhs. So the work certified amount will be rupees 3 lakhs. Work uncertified amount is given as 10,000. So we'll record it on the credit side. Work uncertified amount is given as 10,000. Now let us take the total of both the sides. So the total amount is 3,57,400. And the balancing amount that is appearing on the debit side will be termed as notional profit carried down. So the amount is 57,400. And we'll record this amount on the credit side by notional profit brought down, 57,400. Now let us prepare working notes for calculation of profit to be transferred to profit and loss account. So working note number 4, calculation of profit transferred to profit and loss account. So profit is equal to notional profit into 2/3 into 90%, that was work certified percentage. So notional profit amount is 57,400. So we'll record this amount, rupees 57,400 into 2/3 into 90%, which will be equal to rupees 34,440. So we'll record this amount on the debit side to profit and loss account. Amount is 34,440. And the total of both the side, that is the debit and credit side, is rupees 57,400. And the balancing amount that is appearing on the debit side will be termed as provision for contingency, which will be rupees 22,960. Now let us prepare balance sheet as on 31st December 2013. So capital amount is given as rupees 1 lakh. So we'll record it on the liabilities side. Capital amount is rupees 1 lakh. Next we'll record sundry creditors. Amount is given as 12,000. So sundry creditors amount is rupees 12,000. Next we'll record land and building. Amount is 64,000 on the asset side. Land and building, rupees 64,000. And the depreciation percentage is given as 2% on land and building. So we'll less depreciation, which will be rupees 1,280. So the total amount of depreciation will be ₹62,720. Next, we'll record the work in progress amount on the asset side. So let us take the total of 5,023,403,10,000, which will be amounting to ₹3,38,400. Cash received amount is given as 2,70,000. So we'll subtract this amount from work in progress. So less cash received amount is ₹2,70,000. So the total amount of work in progress is 68,400. Now provision for contingency amount is given as 22,960. So we'll also subtract this amount from work in progress. So less provision for contingency amount is given as 22,960. So the total amount of work in progress will be ₹45,440. Next, plant return amount is given as 9,000. So we'll record this on the asset side of the balance sheet. Plant at stores, which is returned on WDV method, amount is 9,000. Bank balance amount is given as 18,000 in the trial balance. So we'll record this on the asset side of the balance sheet. So bank amount is given as 18,000. Now let us prepare profit and loss account for the year ended 31st December 2013. So in the contract account, on the credit side, loss of plant amount will be transferred to profit and loss account, which is ₹4,000 on the debit side. So to contract, materials lost, amount is 4,000. Next, loss of materials amount is 6,000 will be transferred to profit and loss account on the debit side. So we'll record it plant lost, amount is ₹6,000. Next, in the balance sheet, the depreciation amount is given as ₹1,280. So we'll record this in the profit and loss account on the debit side to depreciation on building. Amount is ₹1,280. Now in the contract account, the amount of ₹34,440, that was the profit and loss account, will be transferred to profit and loss account. So we'll record it on the credit side by contract. Amount is ₹34,440. The balancing amount that is appearing on the debit side to balance carried down to balance sheet, amount is ₹23,160. So the total of the profit and loss account will be ₹34,440 on the debit and on the credit side. So the balancing amount of profit and loss account will record it on the debit side of balance sheet. So profit and loss account amount was ₹23,160. So the total of balance sheet amount will be ₹1,35,160 on the debit side and on the credit side.